Dear learners, welcome to this MOOC on commercial fruit production, pomegranate and guava. Today, we have a first module of this online course. And I am Dr. Madhuri Sonawane. I am your instructor and also coordinator for this MOOC. In today's module, we will mainly discuss the nutritional and economic importance of pomegranate. We will also study the soil and climatic requirements of pomegranate crop. Let us begin with the nutritional importance of pomegranate. In pomegranate, the edible part is the juicy outgrowth of seed. It is also called as aril. These arils are eaten fresh. Pomegranate is very much liked for its refreshing juice. This juice has a high nutraceutical value. That means having nutritional as well as medicinal value. Pomegranate fruit is a good source of carbohydrates and minerals. 100 gram of pomegranate pulp provides 77 kilocalorie energy. This chart gives us the nutritional composition of pomegranate. The major portion of any fruit is the water, and pomegranate is no exception to this. Accordingly, 100 gram of pomegranate pulp or the edible portion of the pomegranate consists of 80% of the water. The remaining 20% consists of 1 gram protein, 18 gram carbohydrates, 0.2 gram fiber, 3 milligram calcium, 0.7 milligram iron, 8 milligram vitamin C, 0.02 mg thiamine, 0.03 mg riboflavin and nicotinic acid 0.2 mg. Now about the uses of pomegranate. Various processed products of pomegranate fruit like bottle juice, syrup, jelly, candy, mixed beverages are very popular. Fermented juice of pomegranate is also used for wine making. Ayurvedic preparation like dalimba valeha are made from pomegranate fruits. Dried seeds of pomegranate known as anardana are widely used as condiment. In addition, fruit juice is valued for its high medicinal value. It controls fever, it is mildly laxative. It is also good for curing inflammation of stomach and heart pain. It is also rich in antioxidants, and that's why it is nowadays considered as a super fruit. Not only the fruit arils, but the bark and the root of pomegranate tree is useful. The stem bark and the root bark contains alkaloids, which are used in preparation of medicine for diarrhea. Almost all parts of the pomegranate tree contain high percentage of tannin. Stem bark, root bark, fruit rind as well as leaves contain tannin. In stem bark and root bark and in fruit rind, the tannin percentage is about 25 to 28%, and in leaves it is about 11%. Being very good source of tannin, all these parts are used in the leather industry. A red color dye is extracted from flowers and it is used for dyeing cloths. Yellowish brown dye is obtained from the rind and it is used for dyeing wool and silk. Economically, pomegranate is very important. The pomegranate belongs to the family Punicaceae. The scientific name of pomegranate is Punica granatum. It is one of the ancient and highly prized popular fruit crop of tropical and subtropical regions. The pomegranate is originated in Iran. The health benefits of the pomegranate have inspired its cultivation from Iran, that is its native region, to northern India as well as throughout the Mediterranean regions of the United States of America, Africa and Europe. In addition to Iran, pomegranate is cultivated in various other countries, mainly like India, United States of America, China, Israel, Egypt, Spain, Turkey, Afghanistan, Peru, South Africa, and Germany. India is the world's major producer of pomegranate. The total area under pomegranate in India in the year 2016-17 was about
216,000 hectares
with the production of 2.6 million metric tons. In India, the total production of pomegranate is concentrated mainly in Maharashtra, Karnataka, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Telangana, and to a smaller extent in Tamil Nadu, Rajasthan, Himachal Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, etc. Maharashtra is the leading state in the pomegranate production. About 64.43% of pomegranates produced in India are from Maharashtra state. In Maharashtra, in the year 2015 and 16, area under pomegranate cultivation was 128,400 hectares with a production of 1.48 million tons. The prominent pomegranate producing districts in Maharashtra are Nashik, Ahmednagar, Solapur, Sangli, Pune, Dhule, Aurangabad, Satara, Usmanabad, and Latur. In Maharashtra state, in recent years, pomegranate cultivation is extended to areas like Buldhana, Washim. These areas are the areas where pomegranate is not cultivated traditionally. The area under pomegranate cultivation has sizably increased with an average productivity of 11.57 tons per hectare. India produces finest edible quality pomegranates, which are available almost throughout the year, and therefore there is actually tremendous potential for export of pomegranates from India. Pomegranate export from India in 2017-18 was 47.33 million tons. It is worth ₹5,037.73 crores. From India, pomegranate is exported to various countries, mainly United Arab Emirates, as well as Nepal, Saudi Arab, Netherlands, Qatar, Oman, Sri Lanka, Kuwait, Bahrain, Bangladesh, Egypt, Vietnam, and Singapore. Now let us see soil and climatic requirement of pomegranate. Pomegranate can be cultivated on a wide range of soils from sandy loam to deep loam. For pomegranate cultivation, soil should be well drained because frequent fluctuations in soil moisture result in the fruit cracking. Heavy soils lead to profuse vegetative growth and less fruit quality and color, whereas in light soils, fruit quality is good, but yield is very less. Pomegranate tolerates salinity and sodicity, and hence it is an excellent choice for arid and semi-arid conditions. It is a xerophyte in nature and it requires dry climate. It grows best in semi-arid climate where cool winter and hot summer prevails. Hot and dry climate during the fruit development improves the fruit quality. For excellent fruit growth, the temperature between 28 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius is favorable. Under humid conditions, sweetness of fruit is adversely affected. Even pest and disease infestation is more. In all, we can say that the pomegranate requires hot and dry climate. It is fairly winter hardy and drought tolerant crop. However, fruiting occurs only under irrigation. Dear learners, I hope you have understood the nutritional and economic importance of pomegranate. We have also studied the soil and climatic requirements of pomegranate. In our next lecture, we will study the details of pomegranate varieties. Thank you.